Thank you, Madam Clerk. All right, this time, we're going to go to announcements. Everybody has very important things to say. However, I would ask that we keep it moderately short. Mr. Gilbert, I know you have to leave.
Thank you, Madam President. The Northside District 3 will be holding our district meeting on Thursday, December 13th at 6 o'clock at Linwood Holt Elementary School at 6500 West Laverne Avenue, at the corner of Hermitage Road and Laverne Avenue.
Your time is up.
Oh, that's the best. That's the best.
That is good.
That is the absolute.
It doesn't feel so good to be on the other side.
That's made by night.
The mayor's impact team and others will be on hand to discuss fiscal year 2014 Richmond budget. And these meetings will be held around the city, but this is the 3rd District Northside's opportunity to speak to this matter. This evening, we did not have a resolution regarding the love lives. Unfortunately, will not be introduced this evening, so I want to apologize for that. But we should get that in at the next meeting of council. But I do want to mention that I really appreciate Ray Boone and the Richmond Free Press for their leadership in making sure that our downtown area is lit up during the holiday season. And it extends, or used to extend, to Valentine's Day. Now we are stopping this after New Year's. But it really does enhance our city. We talk about people coming along 95. It turns a few heads when people come down 95 and see our downtown buildings lit up in a festive way. And so I, this council, I believe, has the task with going forward, want to recognize Richmond Free Press' leadership on this matter. And we will, at the next council meeting, be bringing up this matter, and I will be asking for expedited consideration for this, since it did not make the agenda this evening. And I hope everyone had an enjoyable Thanksgiving, and we look forward to this meeting again Thursday, December the 13th. This is an odd time for our district meeting, but we wanted to coincide this with input on the 2014 budget. 6 o'clock, Thursday, December the 13th at Linwood Holt Elementary. Thank you very much, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Gilbert. Before we go any further, could we have approval of amendments?
The minutes to be approved are from the November 12, 2012 informal and formal council meetings. Mr. Jewell, will you make that motion?
So moved, Madam Clerk.
Councilmember Jewell has presented the motion to approve the minutes from the November 12 informal and formal council meetings. Calling for the vote, Mr. Conley?
Aye.
Mr. Samuels?
Aye.
Mr. Gilbert?
Aye.
Madam Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Jewell?
Aye.
Ms. Newbill?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Mr. Tyler?
Aye.
Madam President Graziano?
Aye.
Those minutes have been adopted.
Okay, thank you. Now, Mr. Samuels and Mr. Connor. Mr. Connor.
Thank you. I'll be brief. Tomorrow evening at 5 o'clock, we have our district meeting. 5515 Bryce Lane, Southside Baptist. That concludes my stuff.
Those are very nice comments. I appreciate your comments. Okay, Mr. Jewell.
Yes, sir.
You passed, right? Oh, you just gave it to Doug?
I just gave it to Doug because I wanted him.
I thought you were doing comments. Sorry, Mr. Jewell. Go ahead. Do you have a comment?
The December 4th town hall meeting for the 2nd District has been canceled. It's time to spend some time with family at the holidays, and I encourage all residents of the 2nd District to do
do just that. Tomorrow night, however, there will be the normal monthly Harbor Area Civic Improvement League meeting. Before that will be the Robinson Street Association meeting. And before that, I'll be attending the Fan District Parking meeting to discuss some proposed changes. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Santos. Dan?
Just want to announce that the Government Operations Standing Committee of Council will meet Thursday at 4:05, 4:00.
Is it 4:05? What time is that?
Tomorrow.
You know, Luke, that baby on me, huh?
Yeah, 4:30.
It's tomorrow?
At 4:30.
It's tomorrow, 4:30.
Yeah, that's what I have on my calendar.
That's what I have on my calendar.
Yeah, it's tomorrow.
Yeah, it didn't show up on my calendar that day, but you're right. I remember us moving. It will be on tomorrow at 4:30, Tuesday. Second floor lodge conference.
Thursday, Thanksgiving, Thursday.
That'll do it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Buell. Mr. Buell?
Thank you, Madam President. I certainly would like to express my sincere thanks and appreciation to Mr. Brian White with Main Street Properties and the Knights of Columbus Holy Rosary Catholic Church for working with me now for the third year to distribute Thanksgiving baskets throughout the East Bend community. And so this Tuesday, we distributed Thanksgiving baskets to approximately 50 households, impacting 150 families to help them have really ensure that they would have a great Thanksgiving holiday. And so with this three-year period of working together with these two entities, we've impacted approximately 315 individuals, really working again to ensure that they have a wonderful Thanksgiving. So again, thank you, Mr. Brian White, Main Street Properties, and the Knights of Columbus Holy Rosary Catholic Church for your support in ensuring a great Thanksgiving for families in the East Bend region.
Thank you, Dr.
Thank you,
Dr. Ms. Farrell?
Last Monday, I was able to attend St. Constantine and Elgin Orthodox Church and pay my respects to the father of those families who passed away. He was not in the city of Richmond, but a lot of things in the city of Richmond. And I think Tom's dash board of art was a big tenant on the father of those because he was I remember when Manoa DePossi and Bill Pan and myself served on council. He was so proud. He was saying that had a great, great memory on city council. So anyway, brokenness and love. It was love for so many. Last Thursday we had our meeting, our district meeting, and I'd like to thank Bobby Benson who attended the meeting and spoke about leads. That's the end of the day. Said 25 bags that the city would pick them up. And also, we had David Cooper there that talked about blighted properties, abandoned properties. And yes, he did let everybody know that city council could not, and neither can the mayor, go into somebody's property and demolish it. Had to go through the process. And we do have a lot of blighted properties, not just in any district, but all of the city, including some city properties that are abandoned and they are eyesore and put neighborhoods. Anyway, we need to work on that, and I know the city council, we have said that we are, and I know that the General Assembly has to also help us with that. Also, we talked about roosters in the neighborhood, and I know that Chuck is helping us with some roosters, not chickens, but roosters that people had in the neighborhoods and they're upset about them. It's a way people are agreed to walk in one. So Chuck is we're working on that. And also the police department was there, the fire department was there. Captain Soel Lane from Forest and Captain Harvey Powers from second gave some updates on criminal activity and some of the arrests have been made, and also they thank the community for working so well with the police department and with all the lieutenants and sergeants and giving up the information that they know. So that's what we keep encouraging neighborhood watches, and we want to start more of them this year because we know that our chief, he encourages neighborhood watches. 1526, bed 646, 1526. The firefighters, not the police officers, but the firefighters will come to your house and they will install these smoke alarms for you incorporated. And if you need a battery, they will put the battery in. And also people ask me, can I go to their nearest fire station? Yes, you can go to your nearest fire station and you can give them your address, your phone number, and set up an appointment for those firefighters to come to your house and make sure that you have a working smoke alarm. Because these working smoke alarms do save lives. They save your home, they save you, they save your pets. So make sure your smoke alarm is working. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Tyler?
Thank you, Madam President. Tomorrow night is the first district meeting at 6:30 at Mary Mumford School. The topic that we will be discussing is West Hampton School. Have a little follow-up on that conversation. Also, we're going to be talking Mark Olinger from Director of Planning and Development Review will be with us tomorrow night to talk about the first pass at the Libby Road Patterson zoning changes. And this will be the first pass, so he is looking for citizen input so that he can begin to craft the zoning ordinances. Also, I believe he will also talk about traffic studies that will be conducted in the neighborhood. Again, it's tomorrow night at 6:30 at West Hampton at Mary Mumford School. Sorry, got too many schools going on in my life tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tyler Robinson. Or is it Robinson?
Mrs.
Mrs. Robertson. The 6th District is having the regular monthly town meeting on December the 8th at the Grace Center on 3rd Avenue from 10 to 12. We also have a meeting with the mayor and the administration is coming to the budget planning meeting in the Florida 6th District. The meeting will be held at Library downtown 6 to 8 on December the 11th, which is a Tuesday. And I also like to inform the council, and we will probably do something first of the year, that the Cannon Creek Greenway, here's my friend Mr. Jewell, the Cannon Creek Greenway was officially adopted into the East Coast Greenway from Canada to Florida this past a couple weeks ago. So
through Richmond, the Greenway ball going nowhere.
Yes, actually going somewhere. So we're really pleased with the fact that the East Coast Greenway is really making traction in Prince City of Richmond, and there are other trails as well that have been added to the East Coast Greenway. And I just want to say, I am just elated at what has happened this afternoon, the fact that we came so far to ultimately get to a place to move this opportunity for running the Redskins and increasing and expanding the quality of healthcare services in the city. Richmond really has, this city is really beginning to be a city to be reckoned with within the region. And people are looking forward to coming to live in the city and do things in the city and have an extremely rich urban fabric to it with the level of diversity experiences that you can have here. So I'm just really pleased with seeing how well the city is moving forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Robertson. I concur with your comments. And my only announcement is that the grand illumination is at 10:06 this Friday at 10, which is awesome. And then Saturday is the Christmas parade. So if you can get to that Christmas parade, it's long, but it's very fun, and it's a great time for family. So having said that, Madam Clerk, would you please read the introduction paper?